Join me right now, Texas Democratic Congressman Mark Vesey. Congressman, with a welcome to you, sir. I'd love to hear your reaction to the situation unfolding in Atlanta.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I heard about it last night and continuing to watch it. Obviously, I believe that the Atlanta police certainly could have served a warrant later. That should not have escalated to the point to where they needed to use deadly force because he stole their taser. They could have. They had his license. They had his information. I believe that that his car was still in the parking lot of the Wendy's drive-thru. And so they certainly could have gone to go and serve that warrant later. And I would have liked to have seen that happen instead.
Yeah, and I still find it just stunning that, all of this escalated, you know, in a period over 40 minutes from start to finish. It's hard to really comprehend. But let me talk about something you're doing. You have a Justice in Policing Act of 2020 that you're co-sponsoring. Tell me what that is and the urgency of Congress passing something like that.
Well, it's really, it's first of its kind legislation, and everyone in the Congressional Black Caucus is supporting this legislation. And what it does is that it holds law enforcement accountable like we've never seen before, because it establishes a nationwide standard for law enforcement. One of the, I think, a few key points in the bill is that it bans the use of chokeholds. It bans no-knock warrants when it comes to federal drug cases. And it also separates that relationship that the police and the DAs have, that they have to keep the public safe. But when it comes to DAs investigating one another, when it comes to DAs investigating police, then that's where the issue arises. We think that, there needs to be a separation there, and that there needs to be independent investigations of police when it comes to situations like what we're seeing in Atlanta right now.
Do you think legislation like this might have prevented what we're seeing from Atlanta Friday night?
Yeah, I think that legislation like this would definitely prevent what we saw in Atlanta last night. And I also think that if you were to end qualified immunity for police departments and they could be held accountable in civil courts, that would really make police departments around the country think twice before they use deadly force and come up with ways to, again, de-escalate situations before they get to the point like where it did in Atlanta last night.
Yeah. You said you have the support of the Congressional Black Caucus. I'm curious also your thoughts on the likelihood that bipartisan agreement could be reached on this. Where do Republicans stand on this so far?
Well, you know, my understanding is that that Kevin McCarthy is saying that that they would like to see something done. I believe that there are senators. I know that, you know, Mitt Romney, we saw him marching with marchers. So we've already seen some bipartisan support on the Republican side in regards to that. And so absolutely, we hope that we can get something done. Hopefully the Senate will after we pass our bill. Here in the next week or so, the Senate will take up a bill and we can work something out in conference. I think the bill that we have is the best route. I don't think that there needs to be very many changes to this bill at all. This is a really good bill that would, I think, stop situations like what we're seeing in Atlanta and what happened to Mr. Floyd. But of course, we need the president to step up to the plate. He's still being very vague about all of this and not being very direct. He still hasn't really spoken directly to the American public about how he feels about what needs to be done in these situations. And we need for him to show that he's the true leader and stop always playing the race card to incite his base.
Texas Democrat.